So in this screencast, I'm going to show you how to do some basic organic group setup, creating a group, adding content to the group, and also adding people to the group, which is kind of the most basic stuff you need to know. Right, I have downloaded the organic groups module, which we can find here in organic groups under modules. We'll need the organic groups thingy here, which is the engine. Or the API thing behind organic groups. We'll also need the organic groups UI for setting up things here. So if I save this, we'll also be notified that we need the entity API module. So make sure you download that as well. And continue. That brings me, as usual, time to have a sip of tea. There it is. So usually when you build organic groups, you do that as nodes. And there are some kind of neat tools for doing that with content types, nodes. So I'm going to show you here. Well, what you do with organic groups is basically that you have an entity, usually a content type that is a group that is kind of container for content. Then you have usually nodes put into that container being the content of the organic group. And then you also have people that are members of this organic group. And I'm going to show you how this works. I'm heading over to structure, content types, and I'm adding myself a new content type. I'm going to call it group. Groups are used to collect content. And so that group members easily can take part of it, or something. Down here, there is a section called group, and you can say that this content type is a group type. You can also make it group content, which is not a good idea right now because you don't want to have, well, you could have group nodes, group types, node types as group content as well, but it will probably be a bit messy. Try it if you feel experimental, but I wouldn't do that right now. This means that this will be used as group as containers for other things. Same that, and wham, there it is, a group content type. I'm gonna leave this page open right now, and I'm gonna edit articles because I'm gonna make articles group content. So I will here, now I'm editing the article content type. Scrolling down, there is a group section here as well. I'm not going to make articles a group type, but I'm going to make them group content type so that articles can be posted to groups. Save this. And then I'm going to show you adding a piece of content, a group. Gonna call it my special group. Here you can see I have a checkbox allowing me to make this a group. I can also choose not to make it a group, just having the node itself for some reason. Some kind of body. This is my body. And that's it. Save. Now I have, since I created this, I became the owner of this node, which also means I'm the group manager. You can see I have a tab here saying that this is a group. I'll come back to that in a second. I will create another piece of content being an article, posting that to this group. This is an article. Some kind of content here. And down here, you can see I have the possibility to add this article to groups. For example, my special groups. This is my groups where I belong, I guess, or possibly where I'm the manager. Say, probably where I'm the manager, actually. Like that. And on this article, it says it has a group audience that is my special group. If I go over to my special group here and reload the page, the article will not show up, which is exactly the way a Drupal 7 version of organic groups works out of the box, and that's perfectly fine. It's not a bug. Because you have to create these lists using views and stuff, and that is actually awesome, because that's the way it should work when you have good API stuff and good exposing of data, then you can do stuff like that with views pretty easily. Right, and we're going to have a look at that in future screencasts, of course. I'm the group manager. This is my special group. I can click on the group tab, and here I can see the people who are members of this group. Right now, it's only me, the root user. If I go back one step, I can add people here. I know that I have an editor user. This drop down here is a bit weird. I can add a membership state here, or choose the membership state. We're going to come back to that in future screencasts. Membership type, also something cool that I'll come back to. Request message, if you're applying for for membership, then a request message here is pretty useful. Add users. If I go back to this group and look at the people, I now have two members here. I'm going to show you also over at the, well, say the editor account. Oh, damn it. I just logged out, did I? Yeah, I did. Oh, crap. Okay, so let's log out again. Thank you, develop module. That was my mistake, not develop module's mistake. Root. Okay, so let's look at my account instead. And edit it. You can see here that down here I have something saying groups audience. This is actually the groups where I am a member. Notes, well, in this case articles, are kind of treated the same way as user accounts, saying that this article belongs to a group and this user belongs to a group is kind of the same thing. But for users, this means that you might also get extra access and stuff. Okay, so what have we done so far? We have created a content type that is used for groups, my special group here. And we have modified the article content type to say that it is a group content type. So it's used for group content. I'm posting this article to the group, my special group. And for some, well, that means it can be listed within this group. You can restrict access to it based on this group and things like that. Right. In the next screencast, well, let's show you first in the organic groups project. There is something called organic groups example, I think. Well, it might be under features here. OG example. That's a module that contains some pre-set up examples of how to use organic groups, which is very useful when you want to get started with it. I'm not going to use it here, but it's a good start. You see that you can see it uses page manager, yeah, and panels and views content page, which are really cool features of organic groups that has an integration with this. We'll see how to use that in future screencasts. In the next screencast, though, we're going to have a closer look at the fields that are actually used for creating groups. You can see here the group content type. If I manage fields here, we have a field here, say, called group, which is a single on-off checkbox. That was the checkbox saying that this is a content group. This is a group. This content is a group that is used for containing other stuff or not. Same thing goes actually for articles. They have a field added called groups audience here, which is two is a special kind of field. Same thing goes for people. Let's see, account setting, manage fields. We have group audience here as well. Telling which groups you belong to, this user belongs to. These can be managed in a special way, as we'll see in the next screencast, but this is it for now. If you think that organic groups is cool, head over to organic groups, the organic groups module, and search for cred here. You'll find this issue, giving cred to the organic groups maintainers, and add your own comment here, because organic groups is cool and it's maintained by the cool people. So why don't you show them that you appreciate their work? Cool. See you in the next screencast. Bye.